God damn. Friday, May 26, 2023. So we're here in Rusty, Rhode Island, and got a little side project going on. Doing some work on this table that about 3 years ago, I was working out in South Tiverton, and just had a wood top on it, and the guy's like, just get rid of it. And I had it sitting in the back. So I cut a piece of steel out of that steel plate that I had in the back, and I welded it on the top. You can see this white stuff. This is salt. What I've done is I mixed salt with water, and where I cut it around the edge, I want to quick rust it. So I'm putting the salty water in, and I keep moistening it. You can see this. This is my patina paint right there in the middle with the rust in it. So if you look at the color, it's getting pretty close to being rust. And again, the salt is going to, where I went with the, I had to clean this up with the grinder after I cut it and everything. And I want to get it to what, to get it to rust back quickly. And that's a good way to get quick rust is just water and salt, especially on a sunny day, and just keep coming out and moistening it. I've been, making aggregate with my this is just a small mortar mixer, and I put all the glass and stuff. Right now I'm doing an old toilet bowl. You can see I break it down and I make aggregate out of it. And I'm going to be putting a load of gravel in here, mostly stone, sort of a stone gravel, and that way I'll be able to bring vehicles back here. Eventually I want to run them steels out too and put it over. It's going to get to it. I'm going to get to it one of these here days. I mean, I've only been going to work on that table for 3 years now, so. But it works out good because I want him to do some work on my signs. So these should be blue instead of black. And it should look. And he did the Coke signs on the Coke truck. I don't know if you remember the Coke bottles that were on the back. You can see them on my video. And he took those repop signs and made them look original old. So, painted the good golf guy, and I think this is the speed I'm gonna go with on this. I got it hooked up to the brakes now. I think this is the speed. And the reason being is if it goes any faster, it wants to make the sign move. I went up to the show the other day. It was moving so fast it knocked it off its stand. I screwed it down to the bed right now. I just threw a couple of screws in to hold it down to the bed. So I've been out driving around checking this out, and everything seems to be working good. Put a set of plugs in it. I changed the oil. Fuel filter's new. The air filter's in pretty good shape. Everything, as far as tune up and fluids are new. So the van truck, had a guy come look at it. He really liked it, but he doesn't want to pay the money, so I had to send him away. I'm not going down a fucking dime. If you want something like this that cheap, go build it. Go try building it yourself. You know, I get mad because I get my hopes up thinking I'm finding somebody who's really going to take on this project and do something with it, and they're just jerks looking for something for nothing, trying to think they're some kind of Richard Rollins going to flip it and make money or something. So I'm going to get a 3/4 ton rear end, I decided. Talking around a few guys trying to find a more modern 3/4 ton rear end with disc brakes. And the wheel, make sure I get the rims and the tires with it. And then I got those coil springs from the Impala that I want to put in the front. So that'll soften up the ride on that. And I think then I'll like driving it too, so I might not want to sell it. You know, I don't know. I mean, it's not like I'm hurting for money. I don't have to sell this stuff. But the idea was to be a business, so what's a business if you don't sell anything, I guess? I don't know.
out from Rusty, Rhode Island, where I just can't make my damn mind up.